Hello guys, how are you? Hope you all are doing well. So guys, today in this session we will start a modeling. But before to move in the modeling part, let me express how that idea come. Basically, I asked my sister for a cup of tea, and after that she told me firstly she has to clean the utensil, and after that an idea came to my mind. Let try for making a utensil, and that utensil name fry pan, right? So let's get started without any further ado. So for this, first of all we will require the primitive shape which approximately belonging to the fry pan. So as per my opinion, cylindrical shape is the best one. So click over this cube icon, and within among the list select the cylinder. It will take some time for loading, and after that we have cylinder in our view, right? So we need to compensate the height, so we have to transform the scale in the y axis. So by default it's the 111, so let we compensate it by 0.3. So it is something like that. I thought it should be something bigger, right? So let's say we will try by 0.37 unit. Now it's look great. Okay, also bring it to the origin. So within the transform position, you can see here the y-axis written as 0.87. So instead of it, we have to make it 0 so that it can be on the center. So now it's lying on the center. That's great. So basically, now we have to zoom it as we have to do the edit part. So let's zoom it and click over this face icon. Now it's asked for the make editable. Click over the make editable part. And now you can see here we get the face. We have to select all the top faces. So click over any face, next zoom it, again click, and again. So now we can see all the faces are selected right now. Let's extrude this face. Why we are extruding, you can see after a while. So let's say we extrude it little bit, right? And now after that we have to shrink it in the x and the y axis. So let's say go with this bar and shrink it by, let's first of all zoom so that we can be more clear, and shrink it by this amount, right? And same thing we have to do with the y axis. So basically this is something what we have, the we have an inner screen, and we are extruding because we have to make us some thinner. After that again we have to click over this position icon, and again after we have to extrude it, and instead of going up we have to extrude it downward, right? So click over the down, go to the front view and check whether it goes right or wrong, right? So it should be something. Bring it something up. So now you can see all seems good right now. No, actually basically this shape remains unselected, and that's why such thing happens. So again we have to come here, select all the faces, carefully select all the faces in order to avoid such a hectic condition. So I thought everything is selected right now, and now we will extrude it inner up to the bottom, because the bottom part should be some thinner, right? So now it seems good. Yeah. Seems great. Right. Now again, since we have some sort of the part outside, so we have to select this vertex. So go on the vertex selection mode, or basically more than the point selection mode, and select this point and bring it out like this. It's going up, so bring down. Yeah, now it's fine. And go to the cube mode. So now you can see some shape is coming. Check it from all the sides, and if any further modification required, you can do by using the selection. And I thought instead of the point selection, it's better we bring the vertices outside. So unselect this, come to the vertex selection mode, and then select this vertex, right? And now bring it forward, something like that. Okay, and we need to compensate it along the x-axis. Okay, that's great. Now it seems fine, right? Okay. That's good. And if any further modifications require, you can do by using this technique. And after that, in the opposite side, we will require a handle. So again, go into the face mode and let's use a knife tool, so that we can cut it along this axis. Just back. Actually, what we are trying just to cut so that we can extrude it more, but God knows why it's not coming. So instead of it, let's we do something else. Select the opposite faces, just come back and select this face and this face. So this is the complete face, and extrude it on the Z direction.
So let's extrude not more than little bit. Yeah, that's sufficient, right? Shrink it on the z y axis. So also check from going back. Actually, one more selection is required. So undo, again select 1, 2. Sorry. 3, 4, all the four faces, and after that we have to extrude it instead of shrinking it later. First of all, we have to extrude it. So click on the extrude icon and bring it little bit out, right? This extrude face needs to be compensation, right? So compensate it over the x axis as much you want or as per your requirement, and the same we have to do with the y axis, right? This will serve as a handle. Okay, and since it's little bit needs up, so up it. I thought this is fine, right? Okay, further we require, yeah, extrude it again. And instead of this, we have to rotate it somewhere. So rotate. I thought this is sufficient, right? And again, we have to extend it, means extrude it over the z direction. Right, and again we have to rotate it. This is the GMO tool, right? So we have to rotate it. Also, I thought we need some shrinkness over the X, so shrink it little bit more. Right. So basically it seems perfect. And now again we have to extrude it over the z direction. So it's come, and let's do it something bigger. And again on the x axis we need to shrink it, right? And as per your requirement you can do modifications. So basically this is what we have, right? So this is our basic utensil for making tea, or something, or by making some modification we can make it as a cooker as well, right? After that we have to provide some plasticness, okay, plastic handle, otherwise it will be hot, you can't hold. So let's again come to the primitive shape and select Q, move it along the z direction and transform it as per your requirement or by checking the proper dimensions as required. So let's turn it and check how much broad we want it. Okay, I thought little more. Yeah, also shrink the height, right? And also the this parameter also. From where is the curl, we have to maintain the handle. Now drag it, bring it little upward, right? and let's provide it a black color. Now rotate it and check. Let's zoom it, seen from all the side. Yeah, seems perfect. Seems perfect. Yeah guys, so we have our handle with our utensil, and now we have to give color to our basic utensil. So here the selection is over the cube. So first of all we have to select the cylinder, right? And after that, instead of coloring, I have a texture downloaded from the Google. You can also download any texture, and I downloaded the silver texture. And remember, the texture should be in the JPG format, not in the JPEG. If by chance you have downloaded the JPEG, you have to simply remove the E and rename as a JPG. Right, so let's go our texture, click over the texture part. It will open the library or the gallery part, and from here you have to select this. I named it still texture. Right, so it's automatically get fitted over your utensil, and you can select any textures like in the same manner. So basically this is our whole utensil. Now we can see, if we move it upward, we lose the handle part. Undo. So to make a complete object, you have to click over the cube and drag over the cylinder. So now it's a one object, and since it's a one object, now you can simply drag anywhere or rotate, right? So let's bring it to the origin again. Bring back to origin, right? So 0, and in the Z direction also 0. So basically this is our utensil for making a tea. Now utensil is ready, and now you can make tea for yourself, right? So let's do some light arrangement so that it can be shine. So again, click over this primitive cube icon, and here you can, we have the option for the camera as well for the lighting bulb sign. Click over this bulb sign, and now we have a light. Bring it where you want so that it can be shine. Right. That I set the intensity to for right to for just testing. So we have written it to. Now you can see the side is now shining. By moving, you can check its influence. So yeah, you can see. Now we have our shining utensil is ready. So guys, this is our utensil for making tea. Yeah, perfect. This is the shadow part, and since light is coming from this side, so it's shining. Yeah. Just for instance, let me give some base. So again, click over the primitive cube. Sorry, instead of cube, select the plane, and scale it just to serve as a base, and let's make light also a part of cylinder so that it can light part can be on with the cylinder. And now let's set bring cylinder upward, check. Yeah, need to bring some little downward. Yeah, zoom it. Seems great, isn't it? And now let's rotate it from all the directions so that we can animate it. So first of all, come to the camera view, and from the camera we have our scene ready. This is looking something this, so set it according as you want. So let's say no. Yeah, that seems fine for right now. And if I want to make it a green screen, then I can select this, but since as our camera not give opportunity for the background, so here we have this filler with us. And now come to the animate part, so select this cylinder. Select this cylinder and click over this modeling. Now it's animating. And start from, instead of 0, let me start from 25 or 30 to animate. Right. So after going to 30, we have to click over this red icon which shows the keyframe setting. And let's say at 150 we want it to be rotate along the y-axis by 360. So come to this part, rotation, and at the y write the 360 so that it have a complete revolution. And now click over this red icon again, so set the keyframe. Now let's try by playing the animation. Yeah, I think one more thing we will require. Actually, since we have inbuilt our light inside the utensil, so only one side is reflected. So let's use one more lighting source. And again, let I increase its intensity by 4. It's too much shining. So instead of the white color, let I select this color. And bring it here, so moving it here. This is, you can according to your requirement. So instead of direction I use the spotlight. And rotate it. I thought intensity should be minimized, so set it back to 2. Again, very high. Set it to be 0.7. Yeah, now it's fine. Let's play. So guys, this is all about the modeling of a flypod. So now we have our flypod with us. And as for the saving, click over this menu bar, and here you have the option for the save. Name it, let's say I say teapot. So guys, this is all for today, and definitely we will meet again with our new modeling or the animation part. Thanks and have a good day to all of you.